This is Healthy Souls with Father Nicholas Lowe, helping you to live a Christ-filled life in today's world. Father Nicholas is the pastor of St. John the Divine Greek Orthodox Church in Jacksonville, Florida.
Well, we're going to begin a brand new sermon series today that I'm really excited about. The title of this sermon series is called Inside Out. And if you're here, I would encourage you that over the next 3 weeks, you make it a point to be with us. Because if you're one of these people that are kind of looking at your life and you see yourself kind of traveling and journeying through life, but you don't really find yourself having a purpose, that you don't really feel yourself really taking that next step in your walk of faith, I promise you, if you're here over the next 3 weeks, it'll be life-changing. If you've ever thought that you just simply go through year after year and no real improvement in your life, you're kind of the same old person you were last January, be here over the next several weeks. And today I want to talk to you specifically about how God wants you to be a goal achiever. Every one of us, God has goals for your life. He has a desire for you to accomplish things that right now you don't think you can accomplish. There are things that he yearns for you to be better at in your own relationships, in your own with your own family, even in your own finances, even the way in which you show love to people. God has a goal for your life. And many of us, I think, deep down on the inside, know that he has these goals for us. The problem is that many times we start out right, but we don't end right. We run a great sprint, but we don't do a good marathon. And study after study shows this. In fact, 80% of the New Year's resolutions that many of us either write down on a piece of paper or even in our own mind, 80% of them, 6 weeks after New Year's, have already failed. Why is it that we as a society struggle to be goal achievers? What is it about the human race that doesn't allow us to be goal achievers? I was looking at this guy's blog a couple of weeks ago, and he was talking about how he wanted to turn over a new leaf in his 2017 and 2018 and 2019. And so he shared his New Year's resolutions that he had in 2017 and 2018 and then now in 2019. And so one of those resolutions, the number one thing, was that he wanted to lose weight in 2017. So he said, in 2017, I want to go to the gym 5 days a week. That's what he wrote down there. And in 2017, he didn't go to the gym 5 days a week. And so he said, well, I'm going to turn over a new leaf in 2018, and I'm going to go to the gym 3 days a week. And he put that on his New Year's resolutions, and he didn't go to the gym 3 days a week. And so then in 2019, he just wrote this. He said, in 2019, I'm just going to drive by the gym once a week. And I think many of us are just the same way. We start out right. We start out well-intentioned, only to kind of fail. But why? And can I tell you, friends, one of the biggest reasons why we fail, not only in our resolutions, but really in being a goal achiever, is because we are not focused on the right way. We're focused so much on the things externally, when God is saying you need to do one thing internally. God's not wanting you to do a whole bunch of things different. He doesn't want you to do something different in this world in 2019. He wants you to be someone different in 2019. Change never happens from the outside in. True change always happens on the inside out. Let me show you how. If you can open up your Bibles, we're going to look at the book of Philippians, one of my favorite books in the Bible. We're going to be focusing on chapter 3. And if you don't know where the book of Philippians is, it's on page 268 in your yellow Bible. We're looking at chapter 3. And just to kind of give you a context of the books that are in the Bible, specifically the book of Philippians that we're reading today, Paul is in jail. He's in jail in Rome, in fact, and he's being tortured there. He's being beaten there. In the Roman system, when you were in jail, you weren't just behind bars. You were literally shackled to the prison, to a guard while you were in prison. So you would have on your feet a piece of chains that would guard, that would connect you to the guard himself. You were constantly connected to that guard. And the book of Philippians is an outstanding book if you'd ever just take some time to read it, if you haven't already. It's powerful. But here Paul is talking about this while in jail. Notice his attitude, notice his perspective, notice how he talks about being a goal achiever. We're looking at verse 12, and I love the heading there. It says, running towards the goal. Listen to what he says. I do not claim, this is Paul speaking, that I have already succeeded or I've already become perfect. Let me just pause. Sometimes in our walk of faith, once we've been baptized, once we come to church, we think that we've already kind of checked this off of our to-do list for the week. And what Paul is saying to all of us is never allow yourself to settle. Paul heard the voice of God, so much so that he fell off of his horse. He was converted, but he never speaks in definitive terms that I'm already there, I can just relax, I don't need to make goals for my life, or for that matter, goals that are not going to be transformative. I keep striving. In the Greek language, the word striving is I am a constant push that everything inside of me is pushing to win the prize for which Christ has already won me to himself. In other words, Christ died for me. He lived his life for me. He gave everything for me. And I just want to give back my life to him. How many of us would approach life that way? That every day that I live my life in this world, it's not for me. I'm just simply wanting to give back my life for the life that was given for me because his life gave me eternal life. Of course, my brothers, I really do not think that I've already won it. Again, he says, I'm not settling. The one thing I do, however, is to forget what is behind me. In many ways, forget your 2017, your 2018, your 2016, but to do my best to reach my 2019. So I run straight towards that goal in order to win that prize. What is that prize? Eternal life, forever living in God's kingdom, which God calls through Christ Jesus to the life above. This isn't the real world, friends. Like you think that, and I think sometimes that this is the real world. The real world is where we're going. That is our homeland. That's what we're constantly yearning to be part of. So usually at these sermons, I'll give you 3 points or 4 points to kind of tell you this is what I want you to do. But today I want to do something different. I want to give you 4 questions that I want you to ask yourself every day in 2019. 4 questions that I promise you, those of you watching us online and those that are here, if you ask yourself these questions on an internal level, it will change your external life. Here's question number one. Am I connecting to God daily? You know, in the Greek language, there's a word called proskuneo. The word proskuneo is mentioned time and time again in the New Testament, in the Greek language, which was written in. The word proskuneo, many of us call it the word worship. We even say, even in our services, which many times. But in the original Greek language, pros is towards, kineo is kiss. In other words, when you come to church on a Sunday morning, you're called to fall in love with God. And it's not this kiss that you would do when you maybe kiss your spouse or maybe even kiss your children. The word kineo in the Greek language means it is an unstoppable kiss that you're giving God every day. In other words, an example would be, respectfully, if you have a dog in your home, and those of you that have dogs that love it when you do come home, when you walk into that house, that dog is jumping all around. He's doing circles around you, jumping and trying to kiss you consistently and profusely. That's what God yearns from you every single time you're in church and every single day of your life. And if we're totally honest with ourselves, many of us, we kind of come to church, and I'll be honest with you, because I was just like this. We're like sprinkler systems. We kind of do this number on a Sunday morning. And we just continuously do that. Or I like to call them maybe even the forklift people. Those are the people that just kind of stand and sit whenever the light goes on and the light goes off. And I get it. It's all good. I mean, we do the same thing. I used to do the same thing. And I just want to encourage you that don't rush liturgy. Don't rush the worship, the kineo, the kiss that God's yearning for you to have. Like God is yearning for you to be here every single Sunday. Not somewhere else, not watching online, here worshiping and kissing on him. I'm asking you to fall in love again with Christ. What does that mean? If you get some time during the liturgy, look on page 17 of your liturgy book. At the very back bottom of that page, it says this statement: I love you, Lord. You are my Redeemer. You are my Savior. I want you to fall in love with Him, that every day, God, if I can just love you internally, all of my things that are dealing with externally, you cope with, you help me with. Second question: am I feeding daily? The Bible says, never allow the Word of God to ever depart from your mouth, because this is what brings prosperity to you. Joshua speaks about this. Notice how he says, your mouth, not your mind. In other words, he's constantly saying, you need to be reading daily your Bible. Ask yourself, when was the last time I just truly read the Bible, not for academic reasons, not just to simply kind of do it just for out of guilt, but truly just sat there and read the Bible and heard how Christ says, I am dying and living my life out for you, that you can live in this world, but you're living in this world, but you're called to live not in this world, but of the world that's coming ahead. That how often do we take time to just let it be, as David says in the book of Psalms, let it be a lamp on my feet, a light to my path. You can do all the works that you want to do externally. If you can't answer these questions internally, can I just tell you, chances are it's going to fail. God's wanting you to be a goal achiever. Third question I want you to ask yourself is this: am I serving daily? Every one of you has a gift. Jesus in the book, in the Bible, says that all of us are called to use that gift to His purpose. Can I just tell you, I'll put it this way. If you're not using your gift for His people, can I tell you, we all miss out. If you're not taking the time to lighten the world, all of us suffer by it. You know, in the human body, I don't know if you're aware of this, there's enough electricity in your human body to light up this entire room. There's a reason why God calls you a child of light. He needs you to turn on your switch. Well, how do I serve? Get involved in the over 30 ministries in our community. Attend our Bible studies. Go and serve at the soup kitchens, the Hubbard House for battered women. Take time, Father, I'm just too busy, I don't have the time to do all that. Can you make a phone call to call someone who's sick? Can you have time to write a card to someone who's going through a difficult time? God needs us to serve Him daily. Last question I want you to ask yourself is this: am I confessing daily? This is an important question that many of us don't like to answer. Every one of us needs an accountability partner. In the church, we call this a spiritual father. And I want you to know this, that some of you are journeying through life never having any accountability. And those of you that specifically are adults, never have any accountability. You're just kind of journeying through life. You're the accountability partner to your child, but who's the accountability partner to you? I want to encourage you, if you've never gone to confession, go to confession. No one's going to judge you. No one's going to look down and say, oh my gosh, what have you done? People are going to love you. The book of James says, confess your sins to one another. It doesn't say confess your sins to God. It says confess your sins to one another. So I want to encourage you. If it's me, that's great. But whoever it may be, find someone that is making you a better person in your walk of faith. Four questions that I want you to ask yourself on a day-to-day basis. I leave you with this. If you're ever in the Lowe household on a Saturday morning, you'll know that Roxanne does not give me much freedom in my house. But the one thing that she does allow me to do is make eggs. That's the only thing I can do in our kitchen. And for those of you that are unaware, I know you're probably wondering, why is this not a white egg? In our home, we like to get organic, antibacterial eggs. And so if it's not expensive, we don't buy it. So this brown egg is what we would have in our house. And so in life, and just follow me on this, okay? We're like this egg. We kind of journey in life, especially at the beginning of a new year. This is like how we are. if a change happens on the outside to this egg, it'll break it. It'll keep it from the new life that God has in store for it. But the egg only fulfills its purpose if it makes a change on the inside that eventually happens on the outside. When it makes a change on the inside, it becomes a new being, a new life that God yearns for it to be. As you journey your life, some of you have external goals, and that's great. But true change can only happen inside out. And I'm encouraging all of you as we begin this 2019 that I'm not looking for you to do some things differently this year. But I am asking you to be someone different this year. It's not about adding a lot of things externally in your life. It's about adding one thing internally in your life. Ask yourself, am I connecting daily? Am I feeding daily? Am I serving daily? Am I confessing to you, God, and to the people that are in my life daily? So that change, when it does come, it can be the best year of your life spiritually.
We invite you to join Father Nick and his wife, Dr. Roxanne Lowe, on the second and fourth Tuesday of every month for their Healthy Minds, Healthy Souls call-in show at 8 Eastern, 7 Central on Ancient Faith Talk.